Greetings, Cloud Gurus. I'm Tom Dean, and welcome to Linux This Month. In this episode, we're going to take a look at recent developments with Alma Linux and Podman, and the arrival of Ubuntu Core 20, Kali Linux 2021.1, and Firefox 86.0. Let's take a look. First up in the news, if you've been crying in your beer over the recent CentOS lifecycle announcement, well, you can stop now. Cloud Linux recently announced the release of their Alma Linux 8.3 release candidate. Alma Linux is here to keep the original spirit of CentOS alive and fill an important role in the Linux universe. We'll take a closer look at what's been going on with Alma Linux in our top stories. You'll want to check it out. The Mozilla team has been hard at work and their efforts have produced a new release. Version 86.0 was released on February 23rd, and it brings a number of new features, including picture-in-picture for viewing multiple videos, improved print functionality, and total cookie protection. Total cookie protection assigns each website its own cookie jar, isolating cookies by site, which gives users enhanced site-to-site tracking protection. In addition, version 86.0 brings a number of bug and security fixes, including mitigation for the stack clash attack on Linux and Android. Offensive Security announced its first release of the year, Kali Linux 2021.1. Now, if you're not familiar with Kali Linux, it's okay. Kali is a Debian-based distribution that's aimed at security-minded users focusing on digital forensics and penetration testing. We'll check out what's new with Kali Linux 2021.1 in our top stories, so don't go anywhere. Canonical has released Ubuntu Core 20, their lightweight, container-based version of Ubuntu 20.04 LTS. This release targets IoT devices and embedded systems and features increased security via secure boot, full disk encryption, and secure device recovery. Ubuntu Core is supported on x86 and ARM single board computers. You know I'll be giving it a try. The container world gets a bit better as the Podman team has released their next major version, 3.0. Podman is a daemonless, open source tool that makes it easy to find, run, build, share, and deploy applications using OCI containers and images. Now, I want to take a deeper dive into Podman 3.0 in just a tick. Enough with the highlights, on to our top stories. Right, we had a few big changes I'd like to explore. Those are Podman's 3.0 release and the arrival of Kali Linux 2021.1. But first, the Alma Linux developments. The recent CentOS lifecycle announcement by Red Hat has a lot of users pondering the future with regard to operating system choice and has led to a lot of shopping around for a replacement. In the last episode of Linux This Month, Ross mentioned several potential distributions you might want to consider as replacements for CentOS, and one was a forthcoming project from Cloud Linux. Well, Cloud Linux has finally announced the availability of their Alma Linux 8.3 release candidate, which was designed to be a drop-in replacement for CentOS 8. Alma Linux is targeting current CentOS users, as well as those looking to migrate away from Red Hat Enterprise Linux, channeling Cloud Linux's 10 plus years of experience of delivering their RHEL-derived operating system, Cloud Linux OS, which boasts over 200,000 installations. With Alma Linux, they're bringing the Linux community along for the ride, with a governing board and a promise to keep Alma Linux free, open source, and supported through the year 2029. The Alma Linux team has been busy, not only delivering their CentOS replacement, but in spinning up the infrastructure and community around it. In addition to the Alma Linux 8.3 release candidate being available, the script to migrate to Alma Linux from RHEL 8 is ready, the Alma Linux mirror list has hit double digits, third-party Alma Linux AMIs are available in the AWS marketplace, and Alma Linux is available from other cloud and hosting providers as well. Finally, the Alma Linux repository is available on the OpenSUSE build service, and the brand new Alma Linux Reddit community boasts over 1,000 members already. So, point your browser over to almalinux.org and get your hands on a copy of the release candidate. The Podman team has also been hard at work, delivering version 3.0 of Podman, the new kid on the block in the container landscape. Podman is the default container engine that ships with the latest RHEL and Fedora-based distributions and is designed to be a drop-in replacement for Docker, but without the daemon. Podman makes it easy to find, run, build, share, and deploy applications using OCI containers and images, and contains features that allow users to migrate containers to Kubernetes and systemd. New to Podman 3.0 is Docker Compose support, which can run against the Podman REST API. Docker Compose functionality is seamless with Podman, with Compose being completely unaware that it's using Podman. Compose requires root at this time, but plans are in place to allow rootless operation in future releases, so stay tuned. Podman 3.0 also brings secure shortname aliasing, which is enabled by default. Shortname aliasing helps protect users from malicious container images by prompting users to confirm the location they are pulling the image from when they use an image's short name. This is only required the first time the image is pulled. Additional fixes and improvements include improved Podman networking, a new version of Builda, the companion utility to Podman that's used to create container images, a security fix for rootless Podman, and more. Podman 3.0 also drops support for the legacy Varlink API, which was deprecated in Podman 2.0. Many additional features, fixes, and changes made their way into the 3.0 release, so be sure to check out the Podman 3.0 release information on GitHub. Offensive security has kicked off 2021 right with the release of Kali Linux 2021.1. Kali Linux is a favorite of the security crowd, packed with security and penetration testing tools. A number of new items have been added to this release. Let's take a look. Just because Kali Linux is aimed at the more advanced crowd doesn't mean it can't be easy to use. The addition of the command not found functionality to Kali Linux 2021.1 means that missing commands no longer return a command not found message, but include installation instructions to assist users. So the answer to a missing command isn't a problem, but a solution. Kali Linux 2021.1 gets a facelift as well, with the default XFCE desktop environment getting a bump to version 4.16 and the alternate KDE desktop environment advancing to version 5.20. Beauty is more than skin deep though, with a number of terminal options undergoing Kalification to extend the Kali Linux theme to the terminal. Kali NetHunter, which is geared towards mobile penetration testing, received an upgrade of the BusyBox engine, and its associated tools have been upgraded as well. Finally, Kali Linux 2021 has extended support on ARM platforms, adding support for wireless on the popular Raspberry Pi 400. With Apple recently bringing the Mac into the ARM universe, releasing new Macs equipped with their M1 processor, and Parallels being first to the game to add virtualization support on the M1 platform, the Kali team is now offering installer and live ISOs to use with M1 virtual machines. If you're lucky enough to have a new M1 Mac, grab Parallels and the Kali ISOs and give it a try. That's it for this episode of Linux This Month. If you like the show, be sure to smash that thumbs up button and make sure you stay on top of the latest Linux news by subscribing. Have a question? Feel free to ask in the comments. May your source remain open and your code compile cleanly. See you next time, and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.